So I'm back to do a very exciting first impression review. These are a bunch of new products from Maybelline for summer 2016, and I just picked them up literally 30 minutes ago. I had to film. I know, I look kind of shiny right now, so I'm gonna explain my whole face. So right now I decided to throw on the color contacts, make myself a little presentable. I know a lot of people don't like them, but hopefully you can bear with them for this video because I wasn't trying to really do much eyeshadow. I did some color contacts, some liquid liner, lashes, threw on a little bit of a new brow product from Pixi I'm trying, because a lot of people love that brow pencil. And I have like a L'Oreal cushion foundation on, tiny bit of concealer. So right now there's no powder or anything like that. Took a picture to use it as kind of a before picture, which we'll bring up in a little bit, but let me show you guys the product. So the first thing is the Maybelline Super Stay Better Skin Skin Transforming Powder, and I picked up shade 30 Warm Beige. Had a little bit of problem with this one because I think I'm between this shade and the next shade. The next shade is Natural Beige, and if you watch me, you guys know I have a little rule about the shade Natural Beige. But I could see from the residue underneath, like just without opening the product, I don't really open products, it's not my thing. It looked a little orange and dark, especially from the color on the front too, it seemed a little too much. So though it might be a little bit dark in this powder, I'm gonna try it out. I think I'm gonna give this its own video. I just wanna talk about it for a little bit because I wanna wear test this. With another product, so that's gonna be its own video, but I wanted to give you guys a little like sneak peek, and then I'm gonna wear this in this video as well, but we'll wear test it. This is the Color Jolt Intense Lip Paint in the lightest color, number 5, stripped down, and I'm gonna put that on in a second. But the stars of this video would be the Maybelline Master Contour Stick. It's half brown for contouring, or you know, half a deeper shade and half of a cream color for the highlighting shade, and these are matte. They don't seem shimmery at all, but if you need some shimmer, this is what you need. These are the Maybelline Strobing Sticks. I picked up both shades, and this is 100 light iridescent and 200 medium nude glow. One is like pinkier and one is more golden, so I was like, screw it, we'll try both on both sides of my face. I ain't going anywhere special. It's all good. So I picked up these at Walmart, and they were about $8 each, and then the powder was at CVS with the lip stuff, and this was about $12, almost $11.50, and this was $10.50. So a little more expensive at CVS. They had the Color Jolts at Walmart, but I already picked it up, so I was like, oh. And then I think they might have had the powder too, but regardless, I got them all to show you guys. They're also available online. I'll link some off down below if you don't want to go hunting your stores if they tend to get releases late. So let's start off with a little bit of powder. I'm gonna grab my Velvet Beauty brush. It has a little sponge. Let me try a brush first, and it has a huge mirror. It doesn't seem to be coming off much onto the sponge. I have to like really dig into it. Crazy amount of shine going on, though I still wanna keep some of my face empty because I'm gonna contour, and I like to contour and all that with like, you know, cream products before powder. But this shade actually looks very good. My forehead,
wait for it,
looks amazing. Oh my god, it's like silky smooth. This might be my new favorite powder, guys. It is beautiful. It is beautiful. Oh my god. Okay, that's a good first impression. I kind of got the sponge all dirty by brushing with this, but let's see. I'm not really a sponge user, but it works just as well. I'm so excited. It has a huge mirror too, because usually powders are really like squarish. I like that, or as DJ Khaled says,
I like that.
Oh, let's do the lipstick as well. I'm gonna just use this as my mirror the entire time. It's a doe foot applicator. And let's see. Let's see. God, there's so many major keys in this video already.
Walk with me through the pathway to more success.
Oh, this smells like lip smackers. Like super fruity. Lip smackers is literally so old school. That's all I had growing up. It's all about that strawberry kiwi lip smacker. Was my stuff. Oh my god, I just got my lips all on the packaging. Yes, getting more presentable by the minute. As far as everything else goes, I'm gonna put my little headband on so you guys can get a good view of my face. Ooh, what side do I want it on? Put it on this side. Cool? Cool. So now you guys can get the cheekbones all up in your face. Ah! We're okay. I dropped the powder. It's fine. I'm fine. Kind of. As far as this stick goes, a little side note, this was the last medium I could find anywhere. They come in medium, light, and deep. And somebody swatched this on their hands because there's a smudge on both sides of this thing and then sealed it back together. So, Jamie from Walmart, I see you. You ain't sneaky. I understand people do that. I get it. But y'all should just wait, you know, wait for a sandwich video. Save yourself the hassle. I understand people do that so they don't have to save themselves the hassle of like needing to return it, but you got me. Hello, subscribe if you haven't. Anyway, so warning, in the car I realized that the stick is like a twisty one and it was twisting so it could smash into the lid. So make sure you twist yours all the way to the left to keep it like positioned down and like tighten it and it won't go anywhere. But if it's loose, like somewhere in the middle, it's gonna, you're not gonna like that. So you have to twist it a little harder to unlock it. And it's kind of like a pointy shape, and otherwise when I think you use it downwards, it might start turning into like a flat stick, but we're gonna get a good view. We're gonna take the highlighting side and put it right there. I would rather have separate sticks personally, but I guess this is convenient for other reasons. I don't know, the triangle. Feels really smooth. This is hard, so fat. Oh my gosh, that was hard to do. Do a little. We'll do the contour part too. Doesn't smell like anything. I felt really good on it. You can't even tell that I used it. Like, too. Grab me a sponge and blend this out. I've always liked Maybelline's face stuff for the most part. There's been a few foundations which, like the Superstay foundation, I didn't really care too much for. If you've seen my review for that, you can check the cards on the side of the video if you need to. But some of their stuff, especially lately, has been getting really good. They're one of my favorite drugstore brands. Let's blend out that contour. This is pretty inexpensive too, to get both for like $8. That's good. I'm liking this. We'll blend the cheek and then I'll take a picture for you guys. Yes, I think you could do another layer if you wanted a little bit more. Oh, I didn't do my forehead. Could do a little forehead action, just a little bit. You really realize if you have a bump in your nose when you're contouring. Make a little contour a little bit more dramatic. Why not? Oh, also, I like to carve out my contour with a little bit of a highlight. Gives you some really snatched looking cheekbones. Blends away really well. There we go. Contour is looking kind of close to fleek. That was level of things. It's close to fleek, not close to on fleek yet. I'm gonna take a picture for you. So you can see in the picture, there's definitely more face like dimension, and my concealer is still reflecting in comparison to my forehead, which has been powdered down. But we haven't said everything yet, but we need to strobe first. So I'm gonna do the lighter side on this side, and then the dark side on this side, just because I can't remember what side you guys will be watching this on. So this is number 100. A little, what was the nose? I don't know. It's like literally just a dot. Number 200, and there's only two shades. Well, this one's very close to my skin. They just like melt onto the face. Ha. This is more of like a light pink champagne, and this is more of a golden bronze. Mm-hmm. So I'm gonna take a little bit of the face powder and then try to get it into concealer area. I should just use the sponge, what am I doing? We're just gonna try to avoid the strobe and just set the concealer, get the highlighted concealer. Okay, so final thoughts. I think the powder is bomb, and that's just off first impression. I love the feeling of the lip stuff. Feels good. It didn't get all over my teeth, and that's nice. That's always nice. The powder again is bomb. I keep looking at it. The contour stick is a nice, subtle contour. If you like a more dramatic contour, you might want to go a little darker, like another shade. Because the medium isn't actually that bad. I could still see the medium working for those who are a little bit lighter skin than I am. I like it a lot. I would never just rock a cream contour by itself. I would set it with a powder, but that's not what this video is about. I'm sure it'll look even better set with a powder. But I like how well it blended, how affordable it is, how easy it applied, how it just felt like it melted into the skin. It didn't drag or anything like that badly. I'm a little scared that like I'd actually hit the wrong side of it. You have to kind of be careful as far as that goes. So Maybelline, if you want to separate them for someone, I'll test that. The strobe is very subtle. I would say it's subtle. If you like a subtle glow and you didn't usually use powder, you just like cream, this is beautiful. You can see that it hits the light. I think both look good. The lighter pink shade, number 100, is more dramatic on my skin because I'm more of a warm toned person. So this one is a little bit more subtle, a little bit more almost natural. I kind of like this. If you really just like a foundation and strobe look, this is very beautiful. And I am very impressed for how much they cost. I like my face right now a lot, especially from a distance. So I'm very excited that they're drugstore. I'm very excited that I could do this video for you guys. So I hope you enjoyed seeing it. Maybelline. Okay, I usually don't like your summer collections, but okay, I like. So if you guys are interested in any of these, I'll link them off down below. And if you enjoyed this quick first impression, maybe I called it a love it or leave it, I don't know, then give it a thumbs up because I enjoy making these for you guys and I just wanna see that you guys enjoy them as well. So that's all I gotta say for now. Thank you guys as always for watching and I'll see you guys in a later video.